Я помню имена, лица, номера. Я помню только пин-код, виза, мастер-класс. Походка от ветра, это я иду в магаз. Куча консультантов меня узнает по глазам. Мой взгляд. In this video, I'm going on bench to build the voltage level indicator. The components which I'm using for this experiment are a breadboard, 5 1 kilo ohm resistors, 5 LEDs with different colors, a jumper wire, and a power supply, which is from 0 volt to 30 volts. I'm gonna start by connecting the green LED to the breadboard. The longer leg is gonna be my anode, the positive, and the shorter leg is gonna be the cathode or negative. I'm gonna connect the LED in a way which cathode is on the right and anode on the left. Then I'm going to connect my red LED. The cathode has to be connected with the anode of the previous LED and the anode on the left side. With the same process, I will connect the rest of the LEDs. Next, I'm going to connect my 1 kilo ohm resistors to the breadboard according to the circuit diagram. This circuit diagram, you can get it at the end of the video. So one of the side of the resistors goes to the anode of the white LED and the other side goes to the positive rail of the breadboard. The next resistor, I will connect it to the cathode of the white LED and anode of the blue LED. The other side goes to the positive rail. Similarly, I will do the rest of the resistors. Now I'm gonna connect the cathode of the green LED, which is right over here, to the negative rail of the breadboard. Next, I'm going to connect my power supply to the breadboard. The positive terminal goes to the positive rail and the negative terminal goes to the negative rail. In general, LEDs have a characteristic called forward voltage or turn-on voltage, which is the minimum voltage required to activate the LED and make it emit light. The forward voltage of an LED depends on its type and color. For example, the green LED, which is right over here, our first LED, has a typical forward voltage range from 2 volts to 3.5 volts. It means that if I start increasing the voltage from the power supply and reach to 2 volts, the green LED must slowly be turned on. As you see, the green LED is slowly turning on. I'm gonna keep increasing the voltage till the green LED completely turns on. So, perfect. As I increase the voltage further from the power supply, the next LED in the series, which are gonna be red, yellow, blue, and white, which they are also connected in series to the green over here, they reach their forward voltage threshold and they also be turned on. This process continues for each subsequent LED in the series, so I'm going to keep increasing the voltage. As you can see, the red LED also turns on. Now it's time for yellow LED. The yellow LED turns on at 6.2 volts. I'm going to keep increasing till blue LED turns on. Blue is turned on at 8.7 volts. And the last one, which is the white one, at 12 volts. So we have basically learned that by increasing the voltage, we are essentially reaching and surpassing the forward voltage threshold of each LED in the series, allowing them to turn on respectively.